In this next one, we're going to be learning about the editing preferences and how to adjust them one by one.
Let's start by opening up the Preference window by navigating to Final Cut Pro. Then select Preferences, or use the shortcut Command Comma. The Preference window will open in the center of your screen. We'll be going over editing preferences, so make sure you have the Editing tab selected. In the Timeline section, this checkbox lets us toggle the Two Up display in the viewer. The Two Up display lets us give a side-by-side preview when we're adjusting or editing between adjacent clips. We'll perform a roll edit. The display shows the end point on the left clip and the start point on the right clip. This is very useful if you want to make precise adjustments when editing. If you want to learn more about how to perform trim edits, be sure to check out our video linked in the description below. We can also choose if we want to position the playhead after the edit. Having this checkbox selected will move your playhead to the end of your edit operation. So, for example, if we create a freeze frame using the shortcut Option F, our playhead jumps to the end of the freeze frame.
Let's undo that and show you something else.
Next, we can toggle if we want to show reference waveforms. A reference waveform shows us the original shape of the sound without any effects applied. For example, if we lower the volume to the point where the waveform is hard to see, we can still see the original waveform in the background. This gives us a good reference, so that we don't have to keep toggling effects on and off when editing. Next, we can change the default fade duration in seconds for the Apply Fades command. You can find the Applied Fades command by selecting an audio clip, navigating up to Modify, Adjust Volume, and Apply Fades. Now you'll see fade handles on both ends of your audio clip. We currently have an audio fade duration set to half a second. If we change the duration, the Apply Fades command will apply a fade with the new duration. This is great if you find yourself using the same duration for your fades, and now you won't have to adjust them all individually. If you'd like to learn more about fading audio, be sure to check out our video linked in the description below. We can also change the default duration for still images, which means if we drag photos onto the timeline, they will be this default duration.
Adjusting settings is easier than you thought, isn't it?
And last, we can change the default duration for transitions. We currently have it set to 1 second. So when we apply the transition, it will be 1 second long. This is a little bit fast, so we'll undo that and increase the duration. If we add the transition again, the transition feels a lot better. Now, if we add transitions to different parts of our project, they will be the same duration, helping us maintain the same timing throughout the video. If you'd like to learn more about how to add still images or transitions in more detail, we'll include links to their videos in the description below.
So if you wondered what was in editing preferences, now you know.
Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.
Look at this, look at that, look at you go.